out his work. These teams, well, they met at the Vienna Major five-star gold medal match, and that went to Molson. Of course it did. They win every gold medal match, it seems, on this tour. But funny story from Charmaine a couple of years ago when the Vikings were on their way up. Alisson and Anders Moll got in a bit of a tiff on the show court. Alisson ended up calling Anders Moll a baby. And since then, Anders Moll has won just about everything. There's lots of respect there now between the two blockers, and I'm sure they share many a laugh about that story. But first point goes to Norwich. Brazil owning up to the first point. So I'm going short on Alisson Sarita. It's interesting to watch this on Alisson because they go short. Yes, it's because Alisson is big and he can take a step in and it affects his approach to spike, but it also takes away his sharper angles. So in theory, it gives less of the courts for the Norwegians to defend against. Passing on wider angles now, Alisson. Sorum sees the chip back to the line. And they're forcing Alisson into certain shots already in this game. Christian Sorum. Well, that one's so good from Sorum because he dances into the angle. And he just gets even more impressive. Good vision. Ferrari starts to go to the line. He's caught moving. But the Vikings here, in the way that they're doing everything, Anders Moll has had injury problems throughout this season. So the off-season in Tenerife has been a little bit fragile for the Vikings. And coming into the first half, they weren't sure they were playing at their best level, but they won it anyway. And speaking to Andy Moll, he just said, "We just hate losing." And that's what he said to me. But at the same time, to maintain the level that they play at with the calmness that they play out is verging on ridiculous, and it's something that we never thought we would see again after the days of Dalhauser and Rogers. Great look again from Christian Sorum. Alisson, for a legend of the game and 6'8" frame, looks like a shadow of a man there after going up and getting beaten to the floor. Great start this for Norway, considering they're at the weekend as well, where the wind's blowing behind them, so it should be advantage Brazil. Two ball, Alvaro Filho. Almost taking matters into his own hands. Probably the most improved player 2013, sportsperson in 2017. Wins on the World Tour for Alvaro with Alisson in Kuala Lumpur, and Espinho was the biggest win for them as a pairing. Christian Sorum scores again. Dominant first end for the Vikings. Performance earlier against Council Wozniak from Poland was sublime because it wasn't their best performance, but they find a way to get through every single game with coolness, calmness, decision making. And that's what makes them so impressive. They win the games that they don't perform at 100% in. Anders Moll made some great blocks in that game. Don't get me wrong, the way that he is 6'7", 6'8", but he plays the game like a smaller guy, getting in, going super low, out the vision of Alisson. This time Alisson wins the battle. They are losing the war here, 6-2. Christian Sorum goes deep angle. Now, there was a period of time where teams stopped serving Christian Sorum, but they seem to be back on Sorum again at the moment. At the World Tour Finals in Rome, the last game that the Vikings lost, and the last time they played on the World Tour before Cancun as well, they lost out to Stoyanovsky Kliselnikov, and Anders Moll was targeted a fair amount there. Anders Moy back in the game, one against Alisson. Remember, Andy Moll made 14 blocks against Varenhorst and Van der Velde in the earlier round. That's unheard of. Kevin Bernstein trying to figure out one of the staff of the Beachvolley Vikings, whether that was a record. They can't remember anyone else getting 14 blocks in one match. That's Andy Moll on the turn. Again, just good court awareness. He knows the situation. He knows that both Brazilian players are committed to the net. Alisson chips over the top. Saw him. Well, the whole game for the Vikings is about reading and seeing what the player's going to do. And as soon as Christian Sørum sees Alisson underneath the ball, leaning backwards, he starts to press round. Well, timeout from Brazil. The Vikings, well, they just turn up and raid every country for World Tour medals, don't they? Vikings have started this semi-final in great fashion. Is that an ace from Christian Sørum? Yes, it is. Now, we look at everything that Norway have achieved, three European championships in a row. Let's remember that it's in a row as well. 11 World Tour wins, winning three times in three different continents, only losing five times in 116 matches. Andy Moll. Alisson shakes his head because I think he thinks that might have not been the smartest swing. He just tried to hammer past Andy Moll. No chance. Andy Moll has got the Olympic gold medalist's number here. That's a better swing. He swings up a little bit more, so he tests the airspace of Andy Moll. Patting away. Alisson again from the left side. Ooh, that one's still going. And the Olympic gold medalist, Alisson, and his partner, Alvaro Filho, they're not too happy, are they? They were so pumped up coming into this game. The Vikings, they just make block defense after block defense, transition after transition. Christian Sørum has only had to side out twice so far in this game. Alisson's almost tried to knock that ball out. This time Alvaro goes on two. That's a tactic that's winning. And the reason why this is happening is because Andy Moll and Christian Sørum have such a good read on Alisson. They can manipulate him into areas and make moves in the block. In the background, you can see Armin Halvig from Sweden. Fantastic defense from Alvaro. Back bump set from Christian Sørum. The ball control is absolutely ridiculous. And then Andy Moll knows that Alisson is moving with him, so he just stays high and goes off the hands. Delightful from the beach volley Vikings. Fast plays. Alisson stuck. Alisson served again. Great read from Christian Sørum. All he's doing is watching through the net. He sees the second ball is coming and he changes his line to match up defensively on the two ball instead of the three ball. So as the two ball becomes more of a threat in this game, the defenders have to be as alert as the blockers. the absolute level Norway are playing at this minute in time is silly. Andy Moll once more. 15-3 Norway lead here. They have been brilliant so far. And Brazil, who are based on a bucket load of ball control in their culture, are struggling with finding angles and space on the court. Chase is on. It's a start that Norway probably didn't even think was capable, was possible even. Looks as if they might just beat Brazil to single digits. That's a rare side out for Anderson Cerruti in this set. He's looking, well, we said earlier, a shadow of a man. And that would maybe be a fitting description of him right now. Too many missed side outs. But he's one of the best the game has ever seen. So we believe he'll come back stronger. Well, Cancun, the host of these three bubble hub competitions. It would be surely one of the greatest achievements for Norway with the off-season they've had, with the injuries they've had, to win back-to-back here before they leave the bubble. They won't be here next week, to my reckoning. Also the last week in the bubble for Krasilnikov-Stoyanovsky. And it's really interesting to know that Stoyanovsky, Krasilnikov are not playing their best volleyball at this moment in time, but maybe they're building for something epic down the line in Tokyo. Previously they've periodized their training very well, where the Vikings have always been on top on the world tour. They've won two of the biggest competitions in the last 2 years. Andy Moll, perfect start for Norway, dream start for them, as Brazil try and work their way to 10. Really do have the perfect read on Alisson. We know that he likes to really bang on the angle and chip to the short line. Norway have found good ways of manipulating their service to force Brazil into certain areas. Even the two ball they're seeing really well back there. Long from Alisson once more. He ends up on the floor. And Alisson is someone that Alvaro, when they won in Espino in 2019, just said, I idolize this man. He's one of the best in the world. Remember, he won that Olympics with Bruno. Bruno stating today on social media that he still hasn't fully recovered physically from COVID, and that's a big, big sign of why Bruno Vandro are struggling out here in Cancun. Cut shot from Alisson. Two will do it for the Vikings. Sorry, shows angle, chips line. Alvaro with an opportunity, but there's a touch off the block from Alisson. So three ball, two ball from the Vikings. Alisson isn't really watching. Nor is Alvaro Filho, and if that was on the opposite foot, you know farewell that Christian Soren would be sat right in the pocket here from Andy Moll. Instead, he's far too central. Alisson is watching Christian Soren. It's maybe just a sign that the game is changing. First set point goes out the back as well. Well, the fans are in here in Cancun. They have to be the other side of the advertising board, as there's Norwegian staff and players. The Beachvolley Vikings look on. Well, there you have it. The Beach Volley Vikings have run away with this opening set. So many transition plays. Great serving, good blocking through good areas of court. Brazil, led by the legend Alisson, have it all to do here. Well, the flags are flying high for Norway. Rightfully so in this sport. Usually Brazil in history who top podiums, but nowadays it's those boys. They really do ooze calmness and the ability to, under pressure, just stay so stable. Well, you'd love to be a fly on the wall there to know what the Brazilian coaching staff are talking about and thinking, because Brazil, strongest nation in the history of World Tour beach volleyball. Norway, the strongest nation in men's beach volleyball at the moment. No question. Alisson starts again. And they're moving him inside a lot of the time, moving him short. And it's to take angles away from him. It's to move him underneath the block of mole, but it's also to get him hitting where they want him to. The Vikings reading the game once more so well. Alisson again from the inside, charging through. He's trying to find a way past the inside hand, of the outside hand even, of Andy Mole. To be honest, if you're Alisson at the moment, you would take a point off any hand anywhere. Vikings have lost twice to Kolesilnikov Stoyanovsky, once at the World Tour Finals, once in The Hague at the Zuider Park indoors. That's quick tempo. And this is something they're adding to the game, the ability to play quick, play sharp. They bump set sometimes, Christian Sørum especially. But just there, first touch is quick, second touch is quick, and they know that Alisson is compromised. Ball control once more from Norway. Or just the tactical awareness. And if it's not Alisson getting rained on, it's not even raining, it's pouring on Brazil, courtesy of Andy Mole. Bring him through the middle. Alvaro tries to hit the leather off of that one. And it's 4-0 again. This is one-way traffic. Alisson from the left side. This time, the difference here is that Alisson hasn't really got a sharp angle, but what he does do is hit up off the hands instead of trying to hit so steep. Mole's drifting a bit, and you can see his reaction. Maybe one block in every 3 points against Fahrenhorst and Van der Velde wasn't enough for Andy Mole. He wants to block every single one. Vikings were just happy to be back competing on the World Tour at the start of this hub now, but they're undefeated as it stands. Older brother Hendrik not out the qualifier this week. Younger brother Marcus on his way up and coming in the beach volleyballing world. That's better from Alisson. He manages to turn the ball at speed away from Sørum and Mole, but that's probably only the second time in this entire match that I can remember Alisson hitting the sand. And they're still forcing him all the time to hit really tough swings to kick out and drive back through. Again, serving on the lines, that they are off the hands this time. the 4-point game, Kristjansson does not miss many side outs. Saw him miss a few today against Kantor Wojciech, but the Polish team did not prevail in the end. They looked absolutely gutted because in the Olympic run-in, Kantor Wojciech, well, it's a great result. It puts them right back into contention after so many injuries. And remember, the Polish team did not play at the World Championships in Hamburg. They missed out on a lot of points there due to injury. Injury has been a problem not just for Norway. But Kantor and Wojciech have struggled with injuries in competition season. Oh, Alisson. What a set that is from the Mammoth. Turning in transition, facing his partner, getting around the ball and just managing to palm it in his way. Great set from Alisson. Alvaro will do the rest there. This is better from Brazil. Serving tougher. A chance in transition. Getting the Vikings off the net has earned a rare break. We haven't seen many of those in the opening set and a half, have we? We really haven't. A rare moment of pure joy for Brazil. Brazil love their beach volleyball. And maybe they can get their way back into this game with some good serving. Almost an ace. Christian Sorum manages to dive and pop that one up. It's another chance for Sorum, and this is just Norway in a nutshell. The serve is a good one off the net band. They got so many teams that would be a point, or at least be a touch there that wouldn't fall perfectly. Sorry, it's Andy Moll that goes to the floor. Sorry, playing right side. Of course he does. But still, the touch is phenomenal. Andy Moll with the side out. I just can't be too complimentary at the moment of the level that Norway are playing. Alvaro on two, this time off the block of Moll. They're starting to find some success here, and once again they go after Andy Moll with an ace. And this is interesting now because Andy Moll has to do the lion's share of the blocking, where he needs to focus and concentrate and look through the net. And if they serve him as well, they might A, stop him blocking as well, but B, pick up a couple of breaks themselves. Fascinating game. 7-7 after two ends. Andy Moll passes that one perfectly straight. Because of that, he has so many angles back across his body as well as going to the line. One of the only other teams to beat the Vikings. Julius Tollet and Clemens Wickler. Wickler recovering from appendicitis. We wish him speedy recovery. Spoke to him before the event or the first time and said, well, it's just part of what I do. I spend as much time with injuries as I do playing beach volleyball, and we just hope he's back at full strength for the game. So if you're watching, Clemens, get well soon. Alvaro. Okay, look at that reaction from Alvaro Filho. Now he's fired up. Alisson's pumping his tires up for a bit of confidence as well. We're back to one. Andy Moll passing on an angle. And then bringing it back to the line. Off the work ball once more. Is really good from Moll. He passed on an angle and he takes some steps to try and stay close to his partner. Just a little palm back to the line. Good vision from him. is much better from Brazil, though. But Andy Moll, they have their read on Alisson. The set's off the net. He's on the floor, and Alisson is not a happy bunny. Fascinating contest. Alisson loves to hit sharp. Loves to turn the ball back to the sideline with power. And then once he sits the defender around nice and sharp, he chips back to the line. Vikings are not allowing that. Now from a center position, the ball control from Brazil. The setting from Alvaro. He's underneath the ball. Maybe that could be it here for Brazil. And the one thing you don't expect with Brazilian beach volleyball is the ball control to be out as much as it is right here. Off the net now for Alisson. Now we see him chip back to the line. That's something that we've never seen him do in World Tour beach volleyball. Not really, just joking. What he's become accustomed to. Bang angle, shoot line. Well, there's the Vikings, Henrik Moll, front row seat here in Cancun. Diving into the angle. Andy Moll beaten this time. He's won a lot more than he's lost. Let's put it that way. Alisson, fourth place with 28 victories on that international men's career individual victory leaders board. And Christian Sørum sits at 19th place with 11 at 24 years old. Anders Moll with 12 wins because he won the one-star event as well when they played with younger players in Oslo, I think, back in 2019, 2018 maybe. But they're already in the top 20 all-time list, and they've got a long career in front of them. And if it wasn't for the pandemic, you know that it would be more. Post-technical, though, a little bit of a battle at the net, and that goes the way of Brazil. They need to win every battle they possibly can. This is a fascinating encounter. Alvaro Filho. He takes two really small steps into the power line. He takes two really small steps into the power line again. Alvaro Filho, take a bow, because that's unbelievable beach volleyball. You've dug Andy Moll twice in a row. Two worldies. And again, what he does off the ball, his eyes hit, he steps round. He knows that Andy Moll loves to hit that sharp angle back across him. He sits there when Andy Moll's head goes up. His eyes look at the ball. He's getting the crowd going as well. Brazil back to one. Tight passing from Anders Moll. Maybe the tables are turning here because Moll has been dubbed twice in the transition. I don't talk much Portuguese, but he seems happy. Vikings could be on the ropes here in Cancun. Well, which way is this one going? The first set was one of the most one-sided sets we've seen in this competition so far. But we know that Alisson, Cerulli and Alvaro Filho, so much class. They've won every game so far in this competition. Wins against Varenhorst van der Velde in the quarterfinal. Gershikov Semenov in 22-20. Oh, Andy Moll. We might see that one on Beach Volleyball World later on. fans loving it. Seen him try to hit sharp angle and then he just pounces one to the line. Well, good from Brazil, but Andy Moll gets the odds back in his favour. Watch again, what players do off the ball tells you so, so much. Let's watch his feet, let's watch his eyes. He goes low and he jumps into the line, doubling up on that side of the court because of the approach line from Alvaro. The game used to be so honest of one player defends the angle, one player defends the line. That's 100% not how it works at this level. They're moving around super late, the Vikings, making reads all the time off what they see. It's one thing knowing what they do, but this is the best part. It's verging on impossible to be able to do it this consistently. They've really mastered the way they play the game. Andy Moll from the inside now. He tries to access the sharp angle back, and that's difficult for just about everyone because he has to go inside out to then chop the ball back on a sharp angle across his body. So 14-0. And that's really good serving from Brazil. We have to give them credit for their service lines there. It's time to the outside of Moll. He strains the ball up pretty nicely. The pass and set is very tight. And this is where the Mammoth will come into his own. He's a legend of the game. He's the reigning Olympic gold medalist. You don't beat him to single figures in a set and see him walk away without a fight. Wow. Surely they're not going to smash and grab this second set. Andy Moll back to the line. It looked as if Alisson was making a late move into the sea. Wow. He saw everything there, Moll, didn't he? The serve is long as well. This is where it becomes interesting because he's getting served, he's having to block, and he's having to serve as well. So it looks as if he sacrificed his spin serve, Andy Moll. Once again, good passing. Chip backs, a really good one. From a high point. Alvaro Filho has a little bit of sand. Yeah, beach volleyballers will know that's not ideal to have a face full of sand. Does get everywhere though. Anyone who plays a game will appreciate the different places. That you can find it. 16-0. Beach Volley Vikings after winning the opener so, so comfortably. This has been a very different second set. Christian saw him serving. Alisson from the outside. This time, roll reversal here. Comes down on Moll's side. Hat's gone from Andy Moll. Don't see so much emotion from him. Alisson's just had a little look through the net, and that was a great shot because with that little look from Alisson, he's starting to believe in himself once more, and that means trouble for the Vikings. That means trouble for Brazil. I mean, it's a game of angles, and when he can face so straight and work back so much on the sharp one, that's gross. So difficult to play. There's no defending it. Rumour has it that Moll's younger brother is stronger than Anders Moll was at his age, which Anders is 3 or 4 years older than his younger brother. So it looks like it's just the start of domination Norway on the World Tour. Alisson. They're at the good end here with a 1-point lead. So it is advantage Brazil, and that looks like it could be a rash one from Moll. Miss side out has given Brazil a 2-point lead here. Well, Brazilian viewers will be on the edge of their seats because, well, it would be understandable if a few fans gave up after the opening set, but not with the way that Alisson and Alvaro play the game. Another side out has gone astray. It's now set point to Brazil. Oh, and that's one way to reply to a couple of spiking errors. This is technically so difficult to do from Moll, to stay so high, so square on, and then work it back across the body. Try it. Two set points for Brazil. They already went to three, or both teams went to three in their quarterfinal matchup. Alisson Cerruti struggled in the opening set, but like all the greats do, they bounce back with a vengeance. Brazil are right back in this one. What a game. Race to 15 to see who goes through to the final. Well, a few teams, including Israel, watching on there. Sean Fiaga had a good performance in the qualifier. Just lost out to the USA. Be back in action on Wednesday for the qualifier. Not much rest for the wicket here. That's how we like it. A feast of beach volleyball in Cancun. And the fans are on the other side of the bubble. That's how it finished. The Mammoth. Beach Volley Vikings. Watch on. As they go to a third set. Yet again. And surely just the law of averages means that eventually something has to give, but it very rarely does. They've had 2-3 setters this week. Cantor Wozniak, they won 15-13. And then Jose Cardenas and Juan Espinoza from Mexico, the 32 seeds, took a random set off of the Vikings. Mammoth goes up, and what's so good about that is he's found his rhythm off of his pass, and he can go up and show the cross court and then hit the line. These are the swings that only happen when passing and setting is in your favor. Andy Moll served once more. It's unreal. You could try, and everything in beach volleyball tells you that you shouldn't be making blocks or defenses on that ball, because he shows so much of the line before whipping it so much on an angle. Jump serving again. Andy Moll's gone back to his spin serve here, and that's to try and put Brazil under pressure. It's exactly what he wanted to do. He set out to rock Alvaro out of rhythm, but Alvaro just, well, maybe got a bit crafty, maybe a little bit lucky as well. This would be some comeback. The Vikings rarely lose a game in World Tour Volleyball, and they won the opening set to single figures. But Brazil just are getting stronger and stronger. And they're in this one. Alisson going back through the years. The battle with Rogers and Dalhauser, with Emmanuel. This just reminds me of one of those high-level epic games that we'll remember for a while, just because of that first set score and the way that Brazil are coming back. That's too good for me. He's looking at his approach line at the end of the point, just living it back. What's nice about Moll is that we've seen that sharp angle back across his body a couple of times, and it really opens up the high line for him. Short on Alisson. They go back to the same service target that worked in the first. Alisson has become really, really astute in the way that he's playing the game. Because in the first set, he was just trying to hit it harder and harder. This time, as long as he shows enough angle and he just chips it and chisels it back, he has a chance. Alvaro Felix. Andy Moll, the target once more. Straight on. He goes back to that sharp angle. And the mammoth, I would say, pops out of nowhere. But he blasts out of nowhere. Look at the shapes from Alisson. What a game. Wherever you are watching from, do not go anywhere. The legend Alisson is starting to get some stuffies on the Norwegians. It was almost two in a row, but this time Anders Moll hits up on it, so he gets the rub of the green. It's not luck, it's a good swing from Andy Moll. Usually what works for Norway is their ability to stay focused. And Kåre Moll was talking about this to me last week, is focusing on their current action and the action they have to do next. They can't lose their focus. Brazil still lead here. There's a change of ends coming up after this point. Norway will want to win it, and they do. That's good for them because they go to the strong end. Tied. So they have a chance to take the initiative once more. Anders Moll, Christian Sørum. Don't lose many. 5 and 116. But they've gone to 3 twice already this week. The tension starting to build. Christian Sørum has been so calm in every situation as he has a swing from the right side, and that's what Christian Sørum does. But what's happened in the past 15 minutes or so is that he's been frozen out of this game from Brazil because they've just gone Moll on Moll all the time. And when Sørum gets a chance, he delivers. Now he has a chance to serve. Get in front of Alisson. He kicks out. He's facing a little bit of line. And he's beaten Andy Moll. And you can hear the scream from Moll. He knew exactly where that was going. So the vision was good. The decision was good. It was just the execution. He's looking at the spiker. A quick step. He jumps completely into the right angle. He can't quite press. And that's potentially just a sign that he's being served. He has to block. And maybe it's getting slightly tired in there as well. Straight approach from Moll. Good vision from Moll, isn't it? This is what I haven't managed to figure out yet. It's the focus that they have. Alvaro kicking himself. Moll, spin serving. It's a good spin serve, but Alisson manages to take a step and keep hold of his pass. But this is what spin serving and service pressure does here to a team, because it's not just about serving aces. He even got in rhythm there, Alisson, but the speed of the pass and the fact that his balance was slightly rocked meant that he lost his rhythm and his approach, and he fired out the back. So good from the Vikings. Certainly isn't bad from Brazil either. What a game this is. Timeout called.
I can hear you guys. I can hear you. Sorry! Yes! Brazil! I can't hear you.
Well, well, well. Who knows what's in store here? It's been another episode of the FIVB Beach Volleyball World Tour that we will remember. The Vikings will serve. Andy Moll's spin serve providing the goods at the moment for the Vikings. Christian Soren back in the game again. Hasn't had much to do, as we mentioned earlier. But two good digs in a row. Soren chips over line, but waiting for it is Alvaro, and then good court awareness for Alisson. Andy Moll, keep an eye on him. He's got his hands on his knees, so physically he's starting to maybe suffer a little bit. As we were saying, he's having to do the heavy lifting for Norway here because Brazil are making him do the heavy lifting. So many moments where Norway are tested psychologically and they come through those tests, but this is another tough one. Brazil are putting up some fight here. Andy Moll turns it back cross court. Once again, coming in straight, trying to turn the angle as much as he can, and then go back to the line once he's established that angle. Alisson and Alvaro doing Brazil very proud here as well. Touch off the hands of Andy Moll, who wants to block every single ball, but at the moment, if you're Cora Moll and the coaching staff of the Beach Volley Vikings, you would seriously just take getting over the line here. Brazil are at the good end. Still another 3 points to play, and that could be a game changer, because no matter what happens here, Norway will go back to the good end. Wind's starting to die down all the same, but they'll go to that good end at least even. If they can score another one, they're going to have the lead. So, advantage to the Vikings here. Alisson is so much smarter than the opening set. So many smarter swings, hitting high off the hands as often as possible, not trying to hit those steep angles or go through the block. Off the net, Soren. What a dig from Alvaro Filho. And we do change ends even. Alisson Cerruti is having a great time here. Alvaro has just made one of the digs of this game. Soren, two looks at the court, tries to hit sharp. Alvaro, he says, I've got you. Alisson puts the ball away to the sideline. Hold on tight. There's a lot of volleyball left in this. Left side, Soren. This game's heating up. Norway have gone back to Christian Soren. And Soren, that was a great swing to start with when he didn't side out because of the dig from Alvaro, but this time he stays slightly straighter on the angle. 1 point game. This is as good as it gets in World Tour Beach Volleyball. Short on Andy Moll. Once again, they're just pressurizing Moll as much as they can. Brazilian legend Alisson Alvaro Filho are having a great game here after a slow start. They would love a break though. Vikings need to side out. Christian Soren passes perfectly in rhythm, but Alisson gets a big one. The mammoth on Christian Soren. And Brazil, well, from two down, have taken the lead here. It's a late move into the angle. It's so good from Alisson. He goes up as if he's blocking the line. Then he makes the move into the angle. What a play. Doesn't the sharpest of angles he was taking, but he didn't need to, onto Andy Mole. They changed the picture, and that's also smart from the Vikings. This is a big, big game of chess right now. Last point before a change of ends. Andy Mole serving into the wind. It's a phenomenal, unbelievable work from Andy Mole. Phenomenal. Just when Norway need a point, and it looks as if they're under pressure, they produce something spectacular. How many players at this situation would serve in the net? No, they serve a rocket. Alvaro can do nothing about it. When you think you see everything on this world tour, you learn something new. Well, this time with the float serve wind behind, just floating the ball in on Alisson, and sometimes that's enough. All this happened in Charmen many moon ago. Alisson stood at the net and started having a argument with Andy Mole. Not this time though. In the serving from Mole, there is no touch. Diving back into the line, Andy Mole. It's match point for the Vikings. And again, they've done what the beach volley Vikings do, is under pressure, they've played some of their best beach volleyball. And it's another three setter. The beach volley Vikings have come past Brazil in an absolute classic here in Cancun. Anders Mole and Christian Sørum. Well, what a game. We can't just single them out. Brazil, Alisson, the legend, the Olympic gold medalist, two-time world champion, and Alvaro Filho. All four players have produced one of the spectacles of this competition.